Now, let's look at some applications of the Gissing sequence in computing cup product. In this video, we're going to give another way of deriving the cup product structure on projective spaces by using the Gissing sequence for this fiber bundle. Actually, let's do it more generally. Let's compute the cup product structure on base space B of a fiber bundle with fiber sphere and the total space contractible. The Gissing sequence will tell us that this cohomology ring is just going to be isomorphic to the polynomial ring in one variable generated by the Euler class. An implication of this is that there exists a fiber bundle of this form if and only if n is 1 or 2 or 4. So let's see why that is. Let's work out the details of this. Alright, so first let's review. When do we get a Gissing sequence? Well, we have a Gissing sequence if either B is simply connected or if we just use the Z mod 2 Z coefficient. Next, observe that the space B is simply connected if n is greater than 1. That's because if we look at the long exact sequence of homotopy groups, and specifically this portion to compute this pi 1, then we see that here, this is trivial because E is contractible. And if n is greater than 1, then S n minus 1 has only one connected component, so this is a single element set. And thus, if n is greater than 1, then pi 1 of B must be trivial, and thus B must be simply connected. Thus, coming back, we see that we have the Gissing sequence if n is greater than 1 for any choice of coefficient r. If n is equal to 1, we will pick r to be z mod 2z. Alright, so let's first look at the case when n is greater than 1, and we will try to compute this cohomology with integral coefficients. As we've mentioned, we do have the Gissing sequence. So here I should write b instead of x. Now, as e is contractible, these terms must vanish. And thus, this map must be an isomorphism. Now, from this isomorphism, we will actually be able to compute the cohomology linked structure of b. Observe that the n here shows that these cohomology groups just repeat after every n indices. Now, since we know that the cohomology in negative dimension are all trivial, we know that these groups here must all be zero. Thus, the non-zero cohomology group are only in degree divisible by n. Now, since B has only one connected component, we know that H0 is just Z. So, as abelian groups, all of these Hn, H2n, and so on, are also isomorphic to Z. To examine the ring structure, though, we need to remember that we get from here to here via cup product with this Euler class. So, we should think of this Hn as being generated by E, and this as being generated by E squared, and so on. Thus, the cohomology ring of B is going to be isomorphic to the polynomial ring in one variable generated by this Euler class E. Remember that this is for the case when B is the base space of this fiber bundle with n greater than 1. Now, for n equals to 1, we can use a very similar argument, but now for cohomology with coefficient in Z mod 2Z, because we will only have the Gissing sequence in the coefficient Z mod 2Z. Then in that case, we have that the cohomology ring is also a polynomial ring generated by one variable, but now the coefficient is going to be z mod 2z. And thus we see that when B is a base space of a fiber bundle, with fibers being sphere and the total space being contractible, then we have that the cohomology ring of B is just going to be the polynomial ring in one variable. An implication of this is that we can have a fiber bundle of this form if and only if n is equal to 1, 2, or 4. This comes from a theorem classifying all possible polynomial ring structure for the cohomology ring. The key idea is to use Steenrod algebra. We can define something called Steenrod algebra, and then it turns out that these cohomology rings with coefficient z mod 2z are actually modules over this Steenrod algebra, and this module structure will force some constraint on it. In particular, we know that if the cohomology ring of B with integer coefficient is isomorphic to a polynomial ring generated by this variable E, then the degree of E must be 2 or 4. In our particular class case here, this degree of this Euler class is just n, so we know that n must be 1, 2, or 4. But that's just a teaser. The Steenrod algebra, let's save that story for another time. For now, let us continue looking at other applications of the Gissing sequence.